But again, the Giants got three in the ninth of this ball game. It was 5-0 going into the ninth. The Giants had the tying run at the plate. Joe Carter, former World Series hero, pop up. Mark Grace got it. Foul territory. The Cubs hang on, and they win the game by a score of 5-3. And you talk about excitement there at Wrigley Field. And I think Cub fans are really drained right now. I know a lot of the media people are. And I'd say it was one draining year for the Cubs, but there's more to come. They face the Atlanta Braves now in the playoffs, so it'll be more excitement at Wrigley Field on the weekend. The Cubs have two games there, and they played hopefully the rest of the series here, a couple of games here and back in Atlanta. But summing it up, I'll tell you, you talk about a great effort by the bullpen. Terry Mulholland, very unusual for a pitcher to come out after pitching a game yesterday and coming back and pitching today. So he pitched a marvelous game today. So did Rod Beck. The entire bullpen to be commended. And Steve Traxel for a great effort and a great starting role. They needed Traxel. They got a great performance. 6 2/3 no-hit innings from Steve. And what more could you ask? Are you all excited?
Unbelievable. I was so frightened, though, at the end there. I saw these terrible doomsday scenarios of a possibility.
Got to keep the faith,
that's right.
Right.
Well, we can relax for a couple days anyway. The streets outside Wrigley the entire game were packed with people. And I know Robin Baumgarten tells us they're pouring out into the streets right now.
They're pouring out into the streets, but they're also partying in that locker room. Let's go to WGN's Dan Rohn. I think it's in the locker room now.
Steve Stone.
I'm here with Steve Traxel, probably the biggest ball game of his life. And Steve, it couldn't have worked out any better. I mean, for you this year, this has to be the crowning glory.
Yeah, that's just went out there and I said, forget it, I'm going to give it everything I got. Went out there and just tried to hit my spots. I was able to do that early. A little disappointed about deliberate walks, but just glad I was able to just kept trying to hit my spots, work out of the jams I got myself into, and just let it all hang out.
Looked to me like you were throwing harder tonight than I've seen you throw in the last couple of months.
A lot of adrenaline going. They came out and said I had 120-something pitches when they pulled me. It felt like I'd only thrown about 40, so my heart was going every pitch, and I was just on a high the whole game.
You got Barry Bonds in some very difficult situations, Steve. Did you bear down a little bit harder on him because you hit that outside corner all night long?
Not any more than anybody else. I just made some really good pitches against him. Just went with what we've been using against him in the past, and I was able to hit my spots, and then luckily I think we caught him guessing a couple times.
Yesterday in the ball game, as the Cubs were going down to the end, you had to be sitting on the bench. Did you have any idea that today was going to be your day? I mean,
I was getting ready to go to the bullpen. I mean, you were there when I asked them, is there any way possible I'm pitching? And they said, no way be possible. So I had a donut for breakfast. Next thing you know, they said, you're going to the bullpen. You might be going out there. And I couldn't believe it. So I didn't have a chance to think about today because I was trying to get ready for yesterday.
Well, you have a lot of people wanting to do it. So yeah. I'm going to go take care of yourself.
Thanks.
And congratulations.
Thanks.
Dan Rohn now with Jose Hernandez.
All right, with Mark Grace back on the field having a little bit of fun out there with the fans. We've got Jose Hernandez here on the inside. Jose, career year power-wise, and it all pays off in a trip to the playoffs. How does it feel?
Oh, it's pretty good. They gave me the chance to play. And, right now we all feel excited, and everybody. We're getting the playoff, and, everybody's got nice season. And Sammy, that's for Sammy right there, get the going the playoffs. So everybody's happy right now. We go Atlanta tomorrow. So we got to celebrate now and go there strong and get those two wins and bring back over here in Chicago and win the rest of the game.
Well, it took 163 games, and I guess you could say it was a typical Cubs victory because it took right down to the final out to get this thing nailed down.
We played pretty good in the first, Traxler pitched pretty good game, and we scored a lot of runs. So I say myself, we got to score a lot of runs. So finally we did. We scored five, and I thought, in the last minute, I said, oh, my God, they can't come back, So I was kind of scared. So now we got the victory, so we can celebrate now.
Can you beat the Braves?
Oh, well, we played pretty good against them, so we got to go there strong and play hard and make a lot of runs. So they got pretty good team too and good pitching stuff. So we got to go there and get to those two games, win those two games and come back home and strong and finally get the Atlanta and Chicago.
All right, Jose, thanks. Congratulations. Jose Hernandez here in the clubhouse.
I'm here with Brant Brown, and in many ways, this is a great year for Brant Brown. Obviously, the one day in Milwaukee, a game you'd love to forget, but that's all over right now, pal. Yeah, you are going to the playoffs.
It's a new start for me, you know. It's been real tough. Pardon me while I get this out of my eyes, but it's been real tough, you know, with going through that. Everybody's been real supportive. I'd like to thank all the fans and everybody who's, you know, written in and called, and, you know, it's just been really, you know, solid, you know, to show the kind of people that we have, the kind of fans that we have. And just like when I gave Ed Lynch a hug, I spit out the hook, you know. I went fishing and I swallowed it, and now I spit it out. So I don't think there's anybody as happy in this clubhouse as me right now.
Well, Ben, let me ask you one question. How important was it to you after that terrible ball game in Milwaukee to get the start the next night in Houston?
Well, I think it was important. I mean, to honestly, if I wouldn't have started, I would have still had the same confidence level. You know, that was one play in many that I, you know, caught this year. So I'd put it behind me. I'm pretty strong individual as far as that is concerned. And, you know, I had put it behind me. I wouldn't have lost any confidence if I didn't start that day.
Oh, Brant, you were great. Congratulations. And now we're going to Dan Rohn, who's got Sammy Sosa.
I got the man of the hour here. Sammy, I think you had a pretty good season, huh?
Yeah, I have to say, 1998 has been unbelievable, not only for me, for a lot of players, especially Mark McGuire. Hey, for me now, it's different. I mean, I was waiting for that moment for a long time. I got it. We have to play extra game to go to the playoff. You believe that? But we got it, especially we here. We do it here in home, which is, you know, it is unbelievable.
Well, I'll tell you what, you got a couple of singles tonight. No home runs, but it doesn't make one bit of difference.
I don't want to worry about a home run no more. I got sick to see. That's good enough for me. Next year, I had to start thinking about home run. What I was thinking about tonight is trying to go out there and relax, make content, and be in base and trying to do anything different because... Everybody wait for me for home run. And
who is that back there?
Every day.
That's Jeremy Gonzalez, for the record. Well, Jeremy's doing Sammy a number here. I hope he didn't blind the National League MVP. Sammy, you'll have to get even with him for that when you guys beat the Braves in the next round.
Oh, yeah. I get him, by the way, buddy. Go ahead.
Hey, we'll let you dry off a little bit. Congratulations, buddy.
I appreciate it, boy. Chicago, you deserve the playoff. We're going to go to Atlanta. We never know what can happen. We might see in the World Series.
All right.
Sammy, how happy are you?
Sammy Sosa, having a great time here in the Cubs clubhouse.
I'm here with Mark Clark, who pitched perhaps the biggest game of his life in Houston. And Mark, had to be a redeemer for you. Been a tough year for you all the way through. They entrusted you with a ball game. If you don't win that game, we're not here right now doused in champagne.
I know. At the time, you know, I didn't really realize it. But, you know, going out there and pitching the way I did and kept us in a ball game and then put us in a position to be here tonight. And, you know, Trax just did an unbelievable job tonight. And about Terry Mulholland coming in there after pitching yesterday. I mean, that's unbelievable. And it's been a great team effort. I mean, everybody battled. Everybody battled their hearts out, and here we are, ready to go to Atlanta.
Well, you guys sure are the cardiac kids, and no better performance than the one in Houston for you. But how about the bats? Where'd the big hits come from?
I can't believe I waited so long to do it, but, you know, it came at a good time. It couldn't come at any worse time than when it did. But we're having fun now.
Okay, take it away, Dan.
All right, here we go. Scott Service is with us. Oh, man. You know, Manny Alexander might be the most dangerous guy in the clubhouse.
Oh, man.
You said you don't like champagne that much, Scotty, but I guess it's an acquired taste.
Oh, it tastes great. You know, it's a long time coming here in Chicago. The fans have been awesome. You know, you look back and where we were, 0-14 at the start of last year, and all the stuff we went through. A lot of hard times for Cub fans and for guys in this clubhouse who are here, and it's nice. It's a nice reward tonight. We'll say hi to everybody back home.
A nervous evening there in the ninth inning. Everything was going so smoothly.
You know it wasn't going to be 5-0. Come on. Everybody's been watching it all year, but we got the job done. That's great.
All right. Hey, congratulations, man. Good luck against the Braves.
Thank you.
Scott Service, Cubs catcher. Getting a little damp in here, you guys.
Here with Matt Mieske. You had one of the big hits today, and Matt, you come up as a pinch hitter. Obviously, the Cubs with a two-run lead at that point. You got to be thinking, if they get anything close, a base hit right here pretty much puts it away. What's going through your mind?
I just wanted to make good contact, have a good at-bat,
wasn't. I just reacted, and a lot of times guys will tell you that's when good things happen. You just react, and I'm just fortunate that drove in a couple runs in that kind of a game. You could tell there's a lot of tension, and it wasn't going to take too much to win it.
Well, for you, a guy who was hitting 300 got sent down to the minor leagues. Now you get a chance to come back, and here you are in a hero in the biggest game the Cubs play all year long.
Well, it was really sweet for me. It was really a tough pill to swallow for me when I went down. I signed here because I thought this team would have a chance to win, and I wanted to be on a winner.
And you were right.
And I was right. I'm just glad that I could contribute. I didn't feel like I had a chance this year to contribute the way I wanted to. And, you know, in the biggest game of the year, I'm just glad that I was able to help us get a win and get us into the playoffs.
Well, Matt, congratulations. It's great. I'm just very, very happy for you. And now we'll take you back to the studio.
All right, wow. Steve, the party is going on there, though. That's you where know, we want to be.
I got to say one thing about this team. We talked about while they're doing the interviews. Of all the teams I've covered, I've been in the business now. Too long. But they are the nicest group of players. Cooperate, win or lose. And I'm so happy for these guys because they are out there every day facing the media and enjoying it and enjoying the year. And it means so much to the fans to see that. They are a good group of guys.
Let's be prepared because Mark Grace, I believe, is getting ready to talk. But in the meantime, we can toss up to WGN's Robin Baumgarten, who is above the party in SkyCam 9. Go, Robin.
Gosh, you know, I'm used to Wrigleyville looking like a whole lot more like Mudville, but you would not even believe the swarms of people out here at Clark and Addison. Take a look out my window, if you will, folks. Here's the intersection of Clark and Addison, just flooded with Cubs fans. And, gee, I hope none of the Cubs players are planning on taking that number 152 CTA bus because it's not going anywhere here. And just in case you're planning on heading down here to celebrate, folks, they have actually blocked off Addison. You cannot get anywhere east of Halsted, and you cannot get westbound on Addison, or westbound on Addison's blocked at Halsted, and eastbound you cannot get anywhere east of Racine. Flooded all along Addison at the intersection of Sheffield and Addison. Waveland's starting to thin out, but you know what? You can tell all this years of frustration are really finally bubbling to the surface here, and it looks like no one's going anywhere fast. Back to you guys in the studio.
Looks under control, though, for now.
I think we're going to throw it to Dan Rowan now, who's down in the locker room. Dan?
All right, back in the clubhouse, we've got Gary Gaetti, Glenn Allen Hill. Glenn Allen, back with the Cubs, second time around. I know it's a lot sweeter than it was the first.
Well, the only thing I'm missing is Harry. Harry was my number one fan, and he loved me. He made me feel welcome. And I know he's down, he's up in heaven, checking it all out. Jesus, smoking a big fat one.
Get some good swings now down in Atlanta. You guys can beat the Braves.
Hey, our team is fearless. We've proven it to everyone. We've come back. We stopped losing streaks. We had big wins. Our veterans stepped up. Gary Gaetti, myself, we're all ready to go.
We're going to drag the guy in here that hit the home run that got the scoring started tonight. Hey, that wind was blowing in pretty hard tonight. Still got it out.
I didn't know, man. I thought Barry was camped under it. And, this is good.
Isn't it fun? I know you've been through it before, but I'm sure it's just as sweet this time.
Oh, it is. Every time, it's just, I'm really glad for a lot of the young guys here to get to do this, man. It's something you never, ever forget. And you know what? They deserve it. We battled hard the last month of the season. I mean, it was right down, obviously, down to the last game. And the guys really deserve to win.
We're still going to talk to you for a sec. Sammy's out on the field right now.
Who?
Sammy's out there saying hi to all the fans.
Sosa?
What do you think of these fans now that you played in front of them and for them now?
I love the Chicago fans. You know, I came from a pretty good baseball town in St. Louis. And, you know, I got to say Chicago fans are every bit as good. I know you're walking down the street, you know, and they have people coming up to you all the time. I mean, awesome turnout, you know, at the ballpark. I bet if it seated 90,000, there'd be 90,000 people here, you know.
And they're partying with you tonight.
And they're good.
Thanks, Gary.
They're
congratulations. Good, terrific. Now let's go to Steve Stone with the guy who got him here.
Here's Ed Lynch, and he's the man that brought Gary Gaetti here and set up all the heroics. And, Ed, you had to retool this team completely from a team that went 68-94. For you, this has to be a great day of vindication.
Yeah, it really is. You know, our Major League scouts did a super job. Larry Himes, Ken Kravec, Keith Champion. They found the guys. I just signed them, and they came in and did a great job. But I think Jim Riggleman deserves the bulk of the credit. And the guys just stuck with it all the way to the end.
Eddie, five runs up in the last inning could have ended any other way than to have to face the tying run yet again.
No, there's no way that game was going to end 5-0. You knew that Barry Bonds was coming up with Jeff Kent as the tying run, and they did, but we got him out when it counted most. So the bullpen was absolutely gone. I thought our whole starting rotation was going to get in there tonight, and Rod Beck was throwing about 60 miles an hour, but he gutted it out and got him out. So we really have to hand it to the veterans that came through in the clutch.
Well, Eddie, you did a great job. Congratulations to you.
Thanks, Steve.
Really. Okay, Danny, take it away.
All right, Stoney, we've got the Cubs' new reliever with us right now, Kevin Tappan, working out of the bullpen tonight and worth every pitch.
Yeah, it was great. It was fun to be out there in a game like that. Yeah, it showed a lot of heart. Terry Mulholland, after pitching yesterday and coming out there, and Rod, you know, he just keeps getting the job done. It's just tremendous. Gary Gaetti stepping up. I wish we could have made his homer stand up for the game winner, because he's been our MVP since he came over here, and, you know, all the guys before him, it's tremendous.
Well, it's a terrific night for you guys, but I know you don't have much time to enjoy it because you're right back down to Atlanta on Wednesday for game one.
Yeah, and that's great. You know, that's the way it's been working all year. We, you know, one tough ball game after another, and find a way to get the job done. And, you know, we'll take a day off, regroup tomorrow, and go at it Wednesday.
Let me ask you one question. I know you want to get out in the field and see those fans, but who's going to be the starter on Wednesday? Do you know?
I don't know. We haven't heard, right? You know, as of today, I was. So, and I didn't throw that many pitches. I hope I get a shot at it.
All right, Tap. Congratulations. Great season. 19 victories. Go get those Braves.
Thank you.
Kevin Tappany. Let's see if we can get outside and see what's going on out there.
There we go.
That's inside.
So Rodriguez having a good time. Would you say he should pour some of that on his ankle?
Yeah, I think so. He's got the bum ankle. Jackie Bang is out and about in the streets near Wrigley as well. Jackie, what's the scene like where you are?
Randy and Allison, I'd like to think I'm a veteran of all the Bulls championships, going to Division Street and so on and so forth. I have never seen anything like this. Take a look at this crowd. There are at least 10,000, according to Chicago police. What they're doing is they are booing because police just arrested a fellow who was way up about 30 feet high in a billboard. What you're seeing now is the crowd of people spilling out from all of the neighborhood bars and spilling out almost immediately. As soon as Mark Grace caught that ball, they started spilling out of Wrigley Field. So it has been this packed with this many people for a good half hour. I think they love the camera. They're pretty well contained, though. There are 150 police officers out here trying to keep everybody in one area. And like I said, from my vantage point, I've seen one arrest from a fellow that was way up on the billboard, about 30 feet high. And a couple fellas tried to get up on some of the city buses, and Chicago police were right there to greet them with handcuffs. Okay, guys. It is astounding, the crowd.
Okay. Thanks, Jackie. And Sammy greeting his number one fans in right field. Little bubbly.
That's his fandom out there. They love Sammy Sosa, and he's giving him a little shower if he can reach that high up on the wall, as the media crews are just all over Sammy Sosa. How much more can he take? But he's a very happy man tonight. What a great scene.
Talk about how classy this guy has been all season long. We all knew that Sammy Sosa had a lot of heart, but who knew that he would carry himself with the kind of grace that he's shown all year?
You got to go back to the White Sox. Sammy, a very quiet man with the White Sox, was very unhappy over there and lost him with the Cubs. Larry Himes brought him over with the Cubs. And this year, though, he's been sensational. I mean, he's really come out of his shell to a great degree, a very happy, outgoing individual. He used to be very quiet in the locker room. You'd go into him, he'd give you comments, but very terse. But let's go back to Dan Rome with more in that locker room. Dan.
All right, well, we haven't heard from one of the key acquisitions in the offseason here in 98. Mickey Morandini, the Cubs second baseman, 1,000 hits a couple of weeks ago, and now this. Pretty good month, huh?
It's worked out for the best. I'm so happy the way things worked out, being able to win this game here at home in front of the crowd. You know, we never make it easy, but the bottom line is we got the job done, and now we're moving on.
Well, that's so true. You know, you have to go 163 games into this to get to the playoffs. And when it looks like you're going to wrap it up in pretty easy fashion, it's 5-0 going to the ninth. You get the tying run at the plate again.
Well, you didn't expect it to be 5-0. You know, you got to give Steve Traxel all the credit in the world. He pitched a heck of a ball game in a pressure situation. You know, Gary comes up with the homer and Matt with the pinch hit single. You need all the guys in this dugout one time or another help this team win, and that's what it's all about.
And it's been a great chemistry all year, hasn't it?
It really has. We enjoy each other's company. We have a lot of respect for each other, and it's been a great ride, and now it gets to continue.
You better get in there and dry off before you catch pneumonia.
I'll be all right.
All right, let's send it back inside the clubhouse to Steve Stone.
I'm here with one of the unsung heroes, Jeff Pentland, the hitting instructor. And Jeff, anytime your team has the kind of offensive numbers this team has, second in the league in runs scored, you have to be in line for a lot of credit. How does this make you feel?
Well, I don't even know what to say, Steve. I mean, it's unbelievable. You know, I always thought we had a chance, but, you know, when it really happens, it was a miracle.
And Sammy hit 66.
Sammy was awesome. He was so fired up today. You know, we had to go in there and calm him down a little bit. I mean, he's swinging the balls over his head.
Well, we got to throw it to one of your pupils right now. So, Dan, with Henry Rodriguez, take it away.
All right, Stoney, thanks very much. Henry, how about it?
This is crazy. I mean, I've never been in anything like this. We worked very hard this year, and we knew we had a chance this year to do something. And everybody saw what happened today. We got to go to Atlanta. It's going to be tough. We know that. Everybody knows that. But baseball, you never know what's going to happen.
And it was tough tonight. It's been tough all season long. You had to go the extra game to get here. I remember talking back in spring training. You didn't know exactly how this was all going to work out, playing that tricky left field out there, and it's worked out tremendously.
Oh, man. I think when I first know that I was coming to Chicago, I said to myself, we're going to be really, it's going to be really good in Chicago because we got Sammy, we got some of the guys that I know. It's going to be tough in playing left field too because of the win. But we worked very hard in spring training. Even after I had my injury, I came back and hit a couple bases for the team. And that's the way it's been for our team. Everybody come through with the team with the big kid hits, and that's what happened.
Well, you can go do Maddox and Smoltz and those guys this week.
Oh, they're tough. They're one of the best in the business. And I think we're going to do what we did here, just play hard and see what happens.
Yeah, look at these guys, Henry, these fans over here. Nobody wants to leave tonight.
They're not going to go nowhere. We ain't going nowhere either, so we're going to be celebrating for a long time here.
All right, I'll see you on the plane tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah, thank you.
Congratulations. Well, guys, you're getting some great pictures here tonight from Wrigley Field. I mean, it has been a spectacular evening. Another difficult one for the Chicago Cubs, but they pulled through in this one, winning game 163. Beating the Giants 5-3, there were so many times during this season where we'd never even imagined we'd see a sight like this in this ballpark. And what a great wild card race it's been. The Giants kind of a late entry there, but the Mets and Cubs going at it, never separated by more than a game from the last month all the way through. And now Lance Johnson is with us. LJ, how about it?
Oh, man, I tell you, this is just great. This is marvelous. This is what you dream about doing when you're a little kid. I've been here before, so, you know, I'm okay. I'm just ready to go to Battle Atlanta.
You're about the driest guy I've seen so far.
Well, you know, I stayed under the AC, you know, when we were inside. So.
Not a bad idea. Hey, well, look at these people up here.
Yeah! Yeah! All right. That's what I'm talking about.
I'll tell you what, you can't beat these fans.
I tell you, they've been great, supportive. It's just a great atmosphere here. It's unbelievable.
Well, if you think it's big tonight, it's going to be a madhouse this weekend when the Braves come back to Chicago.
Well, that's the way I like it. I hope all the crazies come on out and give Atlanta a hard time.
Well, thanks, LJ. Congratulations, and go get those Braves.
Thank you.
Lance Johnson, Eddie Arruza of WGN News standing by at the Cubby Bear. I'll tell you what, the party's going on outside there, too. Eddie?
Dan, I don't have to describe what the mood is like in here. You can hear it. Couldn't get a ticket to get in across the street. This was a place to be. And I gotta warn you, some of these people were feeling good before the Cubs clinched, so you can imagine how they're feeling now. Here are a couple of fans from Racine, Wisconsin, who say they've never lost faith in the Cubs. Here's Ben. Ben, this gotta be a proud moment for you.
Oh, it's been a long time waiting for the Cubbies to win. This is a season we didn't want to end. This has been just a beautiful thing.
Troy, how about you?
Oh, we proved everybody wrong. They said we couldn't do it. We proved in the end we could. It's all that matters.
Bring on the Braves.
Bring on the Braves.
Bring on the Braves.
I'm going to toss it back to you in the studio so people can keep celebrating. We're going to join them here. This is Eddie Arruza live at the Cubby Bear.
Eddie, be careful out there.
Here's a frightening thought for you. Well, what if the Cubs won the World Series? What would be going on out there?
Hey, you never know.
Oh, my goodness.
They've got the first baseman.
I'm just saying we're reacting like this. We're just getting into the playoffs. You can imagine.
Wait, we got Mark Grace. Go to the first base.
All right, go ahead, Steve.
Mark Grace has to be ecstatic. 1989, and here you are back again. 1989, and here you are.
Ross Santo, too. For him, Billy Williams, you know, the guys that, Ernie, all the guys that have been, but Steve, you've been here longer than I have. And, you know, you really don't, there was a lot of times that I didn't think I'd get back to this situation. And I have to thank Andy and Ed and for bringing in the players that they brought in here, not only at the beginning of the season, but also, you know, the guy Eddie's and Glenn Allen's, Orlando Merced's, you know, those type of guys. And I'm forgetting people, but, you know, I just have to thank all my teammates for helping me get back here, because really, you know, it really seemed like I might have to retire without getting back here, and I'm just so pleased and so proud to be a Cub right now.
Before the game, you talked with Michael Jordan. What did he have to say?
I rubbed up on him. I said, if we rub up on Mike, we got no chance of losing. But he was great, you know. But he did airmail that first pitch, didn't he?
He did that. As tough as it's been at times this year, Mark, could you ever have imagined that with Houston just pulling away in the Central, that you guys would have to go to 163 games to get to the playoffs?
Any other way with this team? And would the ninth inning have been any other way? I mean, I was just like, God, I was pacing back and forth, and I was like, come on, let's get these guys out, for crying out loud. We've got a five-run lead. But, I mean, you know us, and it's going to be the same way against Atlanta, I'm sure. You know, we got nothing to lose, man. We're going to go for it, and we're going to show up. I guarantee you, we got a tough task ahead of us, but we're going to show up.
But you had the shooter on the mound, and
you know that
somewhere along the line, he's going to get the ball to you, and that's what
happened. That's right. He did a great job of it, too. Two hands, Mark, two hands. And that's what you want. You want the ball hit to you to end the game, and, you know, I just – man, what a feeling. I'm so happy, Stoney.
Congratulations, Mark.
To you too.
Okay.
Thanks.
Okay, Jackie Bang, take it away.
Alrighty, Steve Stone. We've got an interesting situation going on right here. Certainly the crowd is not dissipated. And a little further off, there is a bus that wants to get through. The Clark 22 bus, and nobody wants to let it through because the crowd is so thick. We're going to, after showing you this crowd, go right to Dan Roan. Sounds like he's got another happy guest. We got Jim Riggleman there. Go ahead,
all right,
Dan.
You guys, Cubs manager Jim Riggleman, soaked to the skin and enjoying every second of it.
Yeah, it's great. I can't describe how good I feel right now, and I'm just so happy for so many individuals, but just collectively, this whole ball club, I'm just so proud of them, and Ed Lynch, Andy McPhail, Jim Dowdle, for what they provided us with here. And, you know, it's a step in the direction we're finally trying to get to, but, you know, can't minimize it in any way. It's a huge step for us.
You got to have a cast iron stomach to manage this team.
Well, you know, I tell you, for me, the decisions that we make, I know people, you know, analyze and criticize and all that, but I've been making these decisions for 16 years, you know. All those years in the minor leagues, those decisions count. And I'm just so indebted to every minor league player who's played for me to help me get to this position where I'm talking to Dan Roan right now.
Well, you know, that's part of baseball. That's part of the fun of it, second guessing by the fans and all that.
That's right. But, you know, hopefully sooner or later they will start to trust. And you know, we want nothing more than this ball club to win, and I just appreciate they're out here to support our ball club the way they do. They love our players, and I think that our players feed off of them so much.
It's really unbelievable, isn't it? The fans tonight, this is the best crowd I've seen in 16 years in this city.
And you know, we got a little boost, I think, early. You know, Trax was throwing great. There's a couple nice plays out there. Merced did a great job in left field. First time he's been out there for us. And you know, we appreciate Michael Jordan came out to get us started.
Gaetti. What about Gaetti and some of the guys you got midseason? Glenn Allen Hill, guys that Ed Lynch and Andy McPhail went out and got for you, have really done a job.
Well, you can put their names collectively in a group, and beside their name, put Ed Lynch and put a feather in his cap for getting those guys.
All right, Jim, thanks so much. Good luck in Atlanta. We'll see you there. Cubs manager Jim Riggleman.
All I'm here with Billy Williams. Billy Williams, for the first time, is drinking champagne in a Cub uniform. And Billy, so many years of frustration for you. And here you are. You got the Cub uniform on, and you got champagne. You're going to the playoffs.
I got the wild card champion on. I got the hat on. And it's really been exciting. You know, we played great baseball, and it wind up the way it did. They're coming back to Chicago and winning for the Chicago fans. The last time I drank champagne was in an Oakland A's uniform. And, of course, this is always nice when you play with the ball club and you enjoying what's happening here. Just good for the guys that win because they played hard all year.
Billy, all those years with all the great teams that you didn't make it, and obviously some of the most beloved Cub teams ever, you find yourself back here as a coach. What do you think this means to the fans of Chicago to once again be celebrating postseason play?
Well, it's really great for them who supported this ball club for so many years. And for us to come back to Chicago and play an exciting game like we did tonight, it was really great. And you're always happy for the players, but you're most happy for the fans who supported this ball club, come out to cheers when time was tough, and it was just exciting to win the wild card. This is just the first step. I think the guys have something else on their mind.
Well, obviously you have to celebrate, but it's tempered by the fact that you got to get on a plane, you got to go to Atlanta. But Billy, you got a ticket to the dance, Billy,
Ticket to the dance. Let's go to Atlanta and see what happens.
Okay, let's take it over to the Cubby Bear.
Steve, this is Eddie Arruza on the roof of the Cubby Bear, where it's a little quieter up here than it was down in the bar, but just take a look down from the roof here at the intersection of Clark and Addison. The celebration has spilled right into the intersection. There are cars and buses that are trying to get by, and the people inside looked just a little bit overwhelmed with all this partying that spilled out into the street. Right now it looks pretty controlled, though. We have a pretty significant police presence here. Some are on horses, some are on foot. And while there's a lot of noise right now, it seems that people are respecting things, and things haven't gotten too out of hand. But there's a beautiful sight there. Holy cow. In memory of Harry Carey, Cubs win. I'm sure he's looking down tonight, probably from a similar vantage point to that we have up here, and really enjoying what he's seeing here. Now back to you in the studio, Randy and Allison.
Harry didn't go on the roofs of many bars, but we know he has been in those areas. We need to explain what happens next.
Yes, because it's kind of complicated. So we've got a graphic. Let's take a look at what's up for the Cubs and the Atlanta Braves. First game is Wednesday. A 3:07 start? That's
right,
kind of unusual, isn't it?
Right here in WGN. Same scenario as tonight with the ESPN feed, but right here in Chicago on WGN.
And then game three will take place on Saturday, October 3rd, and the time will be announced later. So the Cubs are on a roll.
And games four and five after the Cubs win two and send it to five the last one's back in Atlanta. And the paper will have all that for you to sit down and plan your weekend out for. How have they done against Atlanta?
Well, they won the season series 4-2. They swept three games here in Chicago. They shut down the Braves' bats pretty well in that series. So, you know, things are not looking as bad as you might expect. You know, the Braves got great pitching, obviously, but they're not an explosive ball club. I mean, Cubs get good pitching, they can hold them down, maybe win a few games there, and maybe win the whole series.
But you can hear that salsa music playing in the background in the locker room. So can they do the merengue? If they can't do the merengue, we can beat them.
There's also a chance Kerry Wood could come back and pitch.
On the second game, they're talking about him pitching the second game, which would be Thursday, right, in Atlanta. So that could be a big factor. So let's go back. I believe Annie McPhail's down there with one of our guys back at the field, the boss of the Cubs.
I'm here with the president of the Cubs, Andy McPhail. And Andy, it's been a long, bumpy ride, but you're going to the postseason once again. And the last couple times you went, you were pretty successful.
I'll tell you, anything can happen from here on, Steve. We're all 0-0. We're all 0-0 right now. So I've been there when when people start to overlook you a little bit, you can cause some trouble in the postseason, and that's just what we intend to do.
Well, obviously, today was a wonderful ball game, but could you have envisioned it ending a little bit easier than it did?
Well, I guess it was typical. Somebody must have written this script because it was just the way we played all year. Nothing came easy for us. They never quit. It's really a group that you're very proud to be associated with. They played the game the way the game ought to be played, and we all can take a measure of pride in that.
And a guy that you're very familiar with because he helped you win the last time, Gary Gaetti, was the man that put the Cubs on top tonight.
Well, I know Ed Lynch tried to make an effort to bring in winning-type players, and there's nobody in my long association baseball that fits that description quite as much as Gary Gaetti. He's a big-time player. He showed it again tonight, and we're very happy to have him with our club.
Landy, congratulations.
Thanks, Landy.
Okay. Guys, take it away.
Andy, can you either take the jacket off
We're going to let our guys towel off and wring out some of that champagne. Then we're going to come back and do some more out at Wrigley and the areas around Wrigley.
Meringue, baby.
That's right. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Day one on the road,
in the air,
to cover Major League Baseball.
It's the year of the home run, my friends. Jack City, we're watching the big boys launch the long-range missiles over and over again, higher and higher. In fact, this ball right here is a ball that Mark McGwire launched into the propeller of the Bud One airship, proving that he is the Red Menace.
Hey, man, call the FAA. These guys are a threat to our airspace.
Ever wonder where all those SUVs come from? Almost without exception, from people who also put their name on cars. One exception, Jimmy from GMC, the company that sold trucks exclusively for almost a century. Jimmy offers a long list of luxury amenities and also delivers the capability and versatility of an authentic truck.
Get up to $2,500 cash back or get $3,000 in average finance savings with low 0.9% APR GMAC financing. See your Chicagoland and Northern Indiana GMC dealer today, the truck professionals.
Mommy loves you and I can't wait to come home. Okay, honey.
Bye-bye now.
Introducing AT&T Digital One Rate. 50 states, one rate. Never a roaming or long distance charge. So every call is like a local call.
White residents, Barry speaking.
Talk to me, baby.
Hello.
Hello.
And the rate is so low, it can make your wireless phone your only phone.
Pro Performance Creatine. Research showed that creatine increased muscle performance by over 8%. And now during General Nutrition Center's Sports Nutrition Sale, you can pick up a kilo of Pro Performance Creatine made exclusively by GNC for only $49.99. That's only 25 cents a serving. Connect. Live strong. Live well.
There was one Cub that Randy was calling the man yesterday.
Rob Beck calls him the strongest man he's ever met. He probably would have pitched right-handed tonight if he had to. Is that right, Steve Stone?
That's entirely right. It's Terry Mulholland who not only threw eight innings yesterday but came in today. And, Terry, this had to be something that is special for you. What possessed you to tell Jim Riggleman he could use you today?
It's the only game we had to play today, Stoney. And I've always been a guy that always liked playing baseball. And I didn't want to turn around and had we lost tonight and not gotten an opportunity to do something to help the team out, you know, go home and say, damn, I could have done something. But it was a team effort tonight. And I'm just very happy that Riggs had, you know, the confidence in me to send me out there. And I wasn't as sharp as I was yesterday, but you know, I'll take the out.
What was your reaction to the last out of the game?
It was just unreal. I don't smile a whole lot during the season, but definitely put a smile on my face. It was just unreal.
Well, there's the whole ball club pouring out of the dugout, knowing they had made it to the postseason. And the first thing you said to me, Terry, was 11 wins. That's what the team needs right now, 11 wins and two more of these celebrations.
Oh, definitely. I mean, getting a little taste of champagne right now, but, you know, the big mission is to go out and take it to Atlanta. You know, they're an awfully tough ball club, strong pitching, but the great thing about baseball is, you know, good pitchers have bad days and bad pitchers have good days. And you never know. We just go out and play them tough and play them hard for nine innings. We'll see. I like our chances.
Well, Terry, once again, congratulations. And we're going to throw it to Robin in the sky cam.
Thank you, Steve. You know, the Cubs fans don't want to leave. Check out my window, folks. You know, the bleacher bums never want to leave the park. And you know what? Today is proof positive. Check out Sheffield here, just south of Waveland. Fans still hanging around, throwing paper in the air and having a grand old time. You know, don't even plan on going anywhere near the ballpark. They have Addison and Clark shut down all the way through the area. You saw Jackie Bang earlier out in front of the Cubby Bear. It is a mob scene. We'll tilt down and show you the intersection of Clark and Addison again, where Jackie is standing by outside. Still loads of people swarming out here on the street from any corner of Wrigley Field. You cannot get through. And look at that line of buses trying to get through on Addison, not going anywhere fast. You know, people want to savor the victory here, you. And things like this happen once every 10 years. You don't want it to end. We'll throw it back to you guys in the studio.
You can't blame them, Robin. I won't even try to go home tonight.
It was only, what, 6 months ago we were down to spring training, unfortunately, with Harry passing away. Man. It seems like it was just yesterday, but what a roller coaster.
It's been a great year. You talk about memories, this 1998 season. You know, in 1997, everything went against the Cubs right from the get-go. They recall that 0-14 start last year. Well, 1998, entirely different. Everything falling into place for the Cubs. And it began the opening series of the season.
We begin with Game 3 when the Cubs overcame a 6-0 deficit to beat the Marlins in Florida. The tone was set for a year of magic. And as April turned to May, one of the most magical moments of all the year, rookie Kerry Wood tying a major league strikeout mark at Wrigley.
Here comes the hook. Got it! 20 strikeouts! He ties the major league record!
As the weather warmed up, so did Sammy Sosa. 20 home runs in June, a major league record, and the great home run race of 1998 was underway.
Here it is. Curve swung on, belted, deep toward left. He's got 20 this month.
And besides the raw power of Sammy Sosa, there were a few breaks along the way. A game against the White Sox when the ball got stuck in the vines at Wrigley, depriving the Southsiders of a victory. And how about the drain pipe game against the Rockies? The Cubs saved again when a ball hit by Dante Bichette went down a sewer in right field. The Rockies lost a run and lost the game. As the season progressed, Sosa and McGuire dueled for the home run title. Who can forget the night of September 8th in St. Louis when Big Mac got number 62 against the Cubs.
First pitch, rocket deep toward left. He did it! He did it! He did it!
There were more thrills as the season wound down. Down 10-2 on a Saturday afternoon against the Brewers at Wrigley, the Cubs made an amazing comeback and won the game on a home run by Orlando Merced. Wrigley Field was electric. And so again was Sammy on the big road trip in San Diego. The Cubs taking 3 of 4 in a key series. Sosa a huge grand slam as the Cubs, Mets, and Giants battled for the wild card. Nobody could pull away, but the Cubs sure had their chances.
Line drive, deep toward left. Brown back, still going at the edge of the track.
The stunner in Milwaukee, Brant Brown's three-base error costing the Cubs the wild card lead. It finally came down to Houston on Sunday, where the Cubs lost to the Astros on a sacrifice fly by Richard Hidalgo. But the gloom would last for less than a minute, because in Colorado, Nathy Perez led off the ninth with a home run off Rob Nen. The Rockies beat the Giants and created a one-game playoff for the right to play Atlanta in the postseason.
And what a year it was. Some great memories there. More memories, though, as Dan Rona standing by in that happy, that glorious Cub locker room. Back to you, Dan.
Yeah, still having a good time here. Rich, Tyler, Houston, how does it feel?
Tell you what, I mean, you can hear it and you can see it on TV, I'm sure. This is unbelievable. It's a lot of fun. I'm happy for not only all these players, but all the Cubs fans. They're truly the best fans around. They're awesome.
Well, it took you 163 to get to this point, but I'll tell you what, it has been such a team season. I mean, everybody has chipped in. You wound up in that platooning situation there with Scott Service, and both of you guys doing a great job.
It really worked out for the best. You know, Scotty's done real well since then. I've done well. And like you said, it's been a team thing all year. Everybody's picked each other up. We've never won easy. We've never lost easy. But it's been an awesome year. And all I can say is the Cub fans, I'm glad we lost yesterday. I'm glad we got a chance to come here and win this for all you guys in front of you guys so you can celebrate with us.
All right, Tyler, thanks so much. Now, Steve Stone's got the guy that's been finishing all these games for you guys, Rod Beck.
I'm here with Rod Beck, who seems to have a rubber arm. And Rod, you said you could go today after 2 2/3 yesterday and working the day before, and go today you did.
Well, you know, I actually came out to the ballpark today, and so far no one really believed me, but I played catch today, and I actually did. I felt close to 100%, and, you know, I was just able, you know, I was glad I was able to help. I mean, it didn't look like they were going to need me today, and I would have taken a day off, but it comes right down to it. I mean, it's do or die, so it's a beautiful thing.
The last one went to Mark Grace. As soon as you got it inside, saw it was popped up from Joe Carter. I mean,
Did it give you just a thrill? Well, I didn't want to celebrate too early because I saw a couple balls drop there lately. Mickey Morneen dropped one a few weeks ago, and then Brandt dropped one. So I didn't want to celebrate until it was actually in his mitt. And when it fell in his mitt, then, you know, it just broke out. And what a feeling.
Well, Rod, it was against your former team. Was there any special feeling in that?
No, there's no, there really wasn't. I mean, it's a sad point that someone has to go home after today. And I've been the one sent home already. So, you know, I respect the Giants organization. I have the utmost respect for Dusty Baker. And my ex-teammates that are still over there are gamers. They battled hard to get back to this one-game playoff. And, you know, it's just, you know, like I said, sad someone had to go home, but I'm glad it ain't me.
Well, Rod, you're the best. Keep going, pal. Okay. Back to the studio.
Okay, Steve Stone, thank you very much. Rod Beck, 51 saves now. As he mentioned, he wasn't expecting to be in there tonight. They had a 5-0 lead, but he was, and of course saved the game in a gutty effort. I don't know how much stuff he had tonight. His fastball didn't look that zippy tonight, but he certainly had enough to get two big outs for the Chicago Cubs in the ninth inning. You know, putting this thing into perspective, though, the Cubs have not won a pennant since the year 1908. And that's 90 years. You have to be 95 years old or so to remember that thing. It was 5 years after the first flight of Kitty Hawk, and only 32 years after Custer's last stand. That's how long ago it was since the Cubs won a flag. They won the whole thing. They were in the playoffs, of course, 10 years ago in the playoffs in 1984. They've won a bunch of pennants, their last being in 1945, but they have not yet won a World Series since 1908. So it would be great for Chicago if they went all the way. They got a great shot to beat the Braves, I think. It's going to be very tough to advance against Houston. I think Houston's going to come out of that National League against the second team, or the Cubs or the Braves. So it's going to be rough. But the Cubs certainly have the pitching to do it. They stopped the Braves here in a series in Chicago. I mentioned they swept that series here, 3-0. They were 1-2 down there. They beat Glavine. They beat a bunch of people. And Dan Rohn, I guess, is now standing by with one of the stars of the evening, I guess, in the booth. Bill Murray. Dan, it's all yours.
Golly, what a tough day.
It was a tough day then, a great day tonight. I'm glad you were here, Bill Murray.
Well, I'm glad I was here, too. And so, you know, I didn't want to miss this game. I started thinking about it. I was supposed to, you know, I had work I was supposed to do, but I thought to myself, there's never been a game like this before. You don't know if there'll ever be a game again like this, so I was glad I came.
I know they were bugging you to sing, and you said you wouldn't do it until the postseason. This is pretty close to it.
I said I wouldn't do it until the playoffs, and technically this qualifies as a playoff for the playoffs, so it was okay. Nice job.
You'd come down to Atlanta?
Well, you know, the thing about Atlanta is if you go down to Atlanta and you have a drink or two, people take you and throw you in the back of a pickup truck, and next thing you know, you're out picking cotton. You know, I'm gonna play safe and just come here.
All right, well, stay close to home. Right. Come to the games this weekend.
Okay.
All right, Bill, thanks. Let's head back to the
I guess Bill right. Murray, he doesn't like Atlanta too much. Worried about being thrown in the back of a pickup truck there.
He did a good job on the seventh inning stretch.
He did.
So.
Very energetic.
He's a funny guy.
There's one player we haven't heard from tonight, Kerry Wood, who's on that rehab assignment.
That's
so,
right,
Kerry,
right.
If you're watching on the Superstation, ice the elbow and get back up here, and we'll use you in Atlanta.
We had a major role.
Absolutely.
Major role.
Let's take a break, and when we come back, we'll have more of the Cubs celebration. They won the wild card spot.
Stay up late. What the heck, huh?
For the first time, she's on her own, ready to follow her heart.
You make me think about things that I never think about.
Wherever it leads.
This all might be a colossal mistake. But on the other hand, maybe it'll save my life or something. Sometimes it's the smallest decisions that can pretty much change your life forever.
The new series coming to the WB, Felicity.
Premiering Tuesday night at 8 on WGN.
Got a clog? Get the best clog remover. Is it Liquid Plumber or Drano? Actually, professional strength Liquid Plumber clog remover works twice as fast. Yes, there is a best.
Hey, could you shut your lid?
But I'm using Vanish Blue drop-ins.
Yeah, well, too bad your germs don't always vanish.
Huh?
You need Clorox Automatic. With so much Clorox bleach, it kills 99.9% of germs in the water.
Clorox Automatic Toilet Cleaner.
My grandson's a cute kid, but one tough businessman. Hey, buddy, I must have fixed my car.
Up from pricing. What do you think this is, mister? That GM Goodrich Service Plus?
What a kid. Got upfront pricing, plus a lifetime guarantee on parts and labor, plus courtesy transportation. GM Goodrich Service Plus. The little guy was right.
The plus means better.
Call for the select GM dealer near you.
A cold medicine can't work if your child won't take it.
And they're off. Timmy takes the lead. Down the banister. He bolts for the door. But Mom waves the Dimetapp elixir.
Great!
Dimetapp, the number one choice of pediatricians. Even the taste is a relief.
Another breakthrough from the one-hour labs of lens crafters. New Featherweights Plus lenses. They're lighter, they're thinner, they're more impact resistant. And now they're twice as scratch resistant compared to regular plastic lenses. New Featherweights Plus. Only from lens crafters. Made in about an hour.
Welcome back. Looks like the crowds are thinning a little bit out there outside Wrigley.
That's, I'm sure, plenty of diehard fans are still hanging around. WGN's Eddie Arruza has a bird's eye view of everything that's going on. What's up out there, Eddie?
Well, Allison, a lot of the people that were crowding on to Addison and Clark here have gone home, or at least gone someplace else to celebrate. The crowds are dissipating. There's still a lot of folks down here, though, enjoying the moment, relishing this moment, seeing on the sign here outside of Wrigley, saying Cubs win. What a beautiful moment this is out here. But the crowds have pretty much been controlled. They were obviously joyous and celebrating, but we didn't see really any problems from up here. So it was a pretty festive, pretty respectful celebration, and you can hear that it's still kind of going on from down there in the street. Back to you in the studio.
All right, Eddie, thank you. Glad to see you. The Cubs fans are under control.
Absolutely. We have to practice now for the after we beat Atlanta and then Houston and then the Mets, the Yankees.
Safely.
Yeah. You know, a lot of people, when they heard that the Cubs would be coming back to Chicago for this one-game playoff tonight, the workers at Wrigley Field got extremely excited.
Yeah, that's because they thought that they were done for the season. But today, they got one more chance to make the confines friendly enough for the biggest game of the year so far.
Right next to this one. Right over there.
Hours before game time, Mahogany Smith is at work. He oversees the parking lot right outside Wrigley Field. It's where the media park and the stars.
I don't know if you heard that message from 7, but Scottie Pippen's coming tonight.
His job is always hectic, but today was special.
Hey, I was glad for him. I was really glad for him. I said, hey, they did it. They did it, so I said, I'm showing up to work.
Cubs-Giants playoff program here.
Mike LaPapa says he had no problem gearing up to pitch programs today.
I'll tell you what, if you ain't geared up after 81 games, and especially the season we've had here, you're never going to gear up. It's been one of them kind of seasons, so.
Mike Hill is in charge of security for Wrigley Field. You'd better believe he's ready for the extra playing time.
Well over 100 ushers, a good 100 of what we call our crowd control staff. I've got 30, 40 radio units. We've got extra police tonight, so we're ready.
Bunny Minnick is one of those ushers, always on standby for her Cubs.
They called me about 5 o'clock and says, come in at 4:45. And I says, fine, I know.
Were you excited?
Yes, very much so.
They had to call in extra workers for the concession stands today. Dolly Martin usually works the racetrack, but today it's Wrigley.
You get to come to the ball game and you get the paycheck at the same time. What more could you want from life?
But this guy might have one of the toughest jobs at Wrigley. Tom Hellman takes care of the visiting clubhouse. Hey, somebody's got to get the enemy ready to play.
I was on a road trip with them. We had to come back and prepare just like a normal game and set up the locker room and wait for the team to come in. And here they are, and we're ready to go.
So Tom and the rest of the Wrigley Field crew will do it all again on Saturday when Atlanta comes.
Whatever Tom did, the extra starch in the opponent's clothing,
keep
whatever he
it.
Did, do it again. Absolutely, absolutely. So it's big business, certainly, selling Cubs merchandise, but I know we're going to run right over to back to the locker room where it looks like it's quieted down a little bit. Dan and Steve are soaked with champagne, but what a night, guys.
Hey, Randy, talk about starch. These clothes will never be unstiff again, I don't think. But, Steve, these things are so few and far between that I have trouble remembering the last one. However, I don't remember it being quite as fun as this.
Well, remember, 11 more wins to go, and Chip, I know you missed this one. I know you're sorry you missed it, but I'm going to pour a bottle of champagne over your head when I see you next, just to give you the feeling of what it's been like in this locker room tonight. And the guys know, Dan, that there's a road ahead. They've got some tough games to go, but right now, this is one happy bunch of Cubs.
And they did what they had to do. They sold out to get where they got. You know, they used everybody they possibly could. Right down the starting rotation, sent them all down to the bullpen to come out and work if possible or if necessary, and that's exactly the way it worked out.
And I think if you take a look at the feelings of Sammy Sosa and Mark Grace as they embrace and just show the emotion of this night. And Dan, the emotion of this night was something we've been waiting for all year long, and it was a fitting beginning to the end of this season.
We certainly hope that's true. One of those rare years where the Cubs have been able to turn despair into hope and agony into joy as they head on to the playoffs in Atlanta on Wednesday. We'll say goodbye from the clubhouse. See you guys later.
Nice job, you guys. And Steve Stone, nice to have you a part of the